So the Galaxy Note 2 is running the latest and greatest version of Google's Android operating system, codenamed Jelly Bean. The main standout features here really for Jelly Bean and for what Samsung have done in general to integrate their TouchWiz operating system, the Samsung features and apps, and then into the Jelly Bean operating system has been beautifully done. If you've already got hold of the Samsung Galaxy S3 update for Jelly Bean, then not a huge number of surprises here. If you're brand new to Jelly Bean, if you've previously coming from Ice Cream Sandwich or something like that, you're in for a real treat. Okay, so first off, the major changes are the notification area. The notification area has been completely overhauled now to make it much more user-friendly. Notifications can provide expanded information if the application has been set up for it, and Samsung have added their own quick lock shortcut bar at the top, and the brightness controls work really nicely, and you have settings available at the top here. If you tap that, you go straight into your settings. On your button placements, you have a long press button here, which is actually your back button as well, and that will bring up the multi-window support, which allows you to run two applications simultaneously. Long pressing on the home button brings up the running tasks list, which you can then quickly close if you want to, and that will clear all of your running tasks. This option on the side, on the left-hand side, takes you into your applications that are installed, your system memory, 1.75 gig available. Beautiful, let's just clear that down. And your storage. If you long press but go into the center option, it will take you into the Google Now functionality, which is new from Google for Jelly Bean. And what this provides is contextual based information about what you are doing. So for instance, what's the weather like today where I am? If I happen to be going out to a meeting, it will check to see whether the traffic is bad, and it will reroute me if necessary. And it will tell me, would you like to be rerouted? There's bad traffic, it's going to add an extra 10 minutes onto your journey. It will provide the latest sports results. If you happen to be stood at a bus stop or outside a cinema, it will provide the latest listings or bus timetables for you, so you know exactly how long you're going to be waiting for your movie or when the next bus is going to be coming along. This level of deep integration with the handset is absolutely fantastic, and on quite a few occasions now I found it really, really useful. Something certainly to check out. You can access it also via this Google search strip here, which you can also use to trigger the Google voice service as well, which will then produce a search for you based on what you've said. It can search through images and absolutely anything you need, but all powered by Google services. A really, really nice introduction, and it completely out-series Siri. One of the pieces of functionality that Samsung have included, which I'm not a big fan of, is S-Voice. It's their version of Siri. Personally, I don't think it works very well. It's better at some things than Siri and worse than at others. Personally, I've disabled it. I much prefer Google Now, and I really don't think Samsung will continue with S-Voice for too many years. I think Google Now will effectively take over from it. But, you know, good on Samsung for at least putting the functionality in there of voice assistants, but, you know, none of them work very well. I think Google have kind of got the one-up on that one by not really doing personalised voice searching as such, but really relying on the data it holds about us to produce better voice responses and provide data alongside that. All in all, the Jelly Bean functionality is a massive improvement over, you know, a previous Ice Cream Sandwich on the same hardware. The responsiveness of the screen, how quickly menus open and applications load, is absolutely stunning. And, you know, whilst this does have a faster processor, more RAM, we've seen very, very similar speed gains and performance boosts on any device that gets Jelly Bean installed onto it. Everything is much more snappy. So if you're coming from an older handset for Android, or if you're coming from an old iPhone, you will really notice the difference in speed. If you're one of those people who has an existing Android phone and you're just waiting for Jelly Bean at the moment, don't be too alarmed that there's a new device that's come out that's faster. Wait until you get Jelly Bean, you'll find your phone will suddenly be like brand new again. Very, very quick and responsive. A lot of the software is pretty much standard from an Android perspective. Some of the new Samsung applications that they've added on are really more updates to the existing stuff to take account of things like the S Pen. So S Note and S Planner have been updated to make use of the S Pen feature. You now have Paper Artist, which is really just a fun little drawing game. They've added a Reader's Hub, which is really like a Samsung books and subscription service. A lot of the time you kind of think, they're duplicating applications that Google already provide, like a Samsung Apps. Why have Samsung Apps if you have Google Apps, which have all of the same apps in there? Occasionally a little bit cheaper, sometimes a bit more expensive. It doesn't really make a right lot of sense. They've also bundled Dropbox, ChatOn, which is Samsung's chat app, a bit like WhatsApp. The Learning Hub, which for the life of me, I don't really know why that's been included, but I think they're aiming this very much at people in academia as well. So you have like a periodicals and journals option in there as well. And then really the standard Google stuff, like Google Maps is there. Flipboard has also been included by Samsung, has as AllShare, which is their DLNA sharing tool. There's also the Music Hub and Game Hub as well. Most of the time, though, you will find that you'll be defaulting back to the Google ones because they're what you know and love. Although I must say, I do actually quite like Music Hub and Music app that they've installed from Samsung, Music Player, should I say. It does quite a good job, and it's quite pleasing to use. I always found that the Music app on iOS 6, oh well, on any Apple product, was always a bit lackluster, really. Great sound quality and all, but not really the best app experience. I think they've got it really, really well done on the Galaxy Note 2.